Spirit, lead me and guide me. 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 Every day I see in a new way, living my life to the fullest every day. There's nothing sweeter than that smile on my face. I just surrender to that power and love every moment, every day. Spirit, lead me and guide me. Spirit, just keeps on giving me. Spirit, just let it lead me and guide me. Spirit, just keeps on giving me. It's up to me to be that brighter day, because I am that I am. It supports me with yes in every way. So I surrender to that power in love every moment, every day. Oh, 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 oh. It's only love. See, it's all there is, all there'll ever be. It's up to me to know and receive, and know there's only one life, love, peace, and harmony. Oh, it's only Spirit living in me. Spirit, lead you and guide you. Spirit, will just keep on giving you. Spirit, just let it lead you and guide you. Spirit, just keeps on giving you. When you find yourself going through the dark night of the soul, just release and let go and know that it's all, then surrender to that power and love every moment, every day. It's only love. See, it's all there is, all there'll ever be. It's up to me to know and believe, and know there's only one life, love, peace, and harmony. Oh, it's only Spirit living in me. Spirit, lead me and guide me. Spirit, just keeps on giving me. Spirit, just let it lead me and guide me. Spirit, just keeps on giving me. It's only love. All there is, all there'll ever be. It's up to me. Oh, it's only Spirit living. Oh, it's only Spirit living in me. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Reverend Bonnie Anderson, and this is my husband, Reverend Andy Anderson, and we're just delighted to be back. It's been quite a few, maybe 2 or 3 years since we've been here, and we're just delighted to be back with all of you. It's one of our favorite places. And since we saw you last, probably we have retired from the Roseburg Church, and now we're traveling around. We're sort of troubadours. We travel around and speak at churches all over, from Canada to everywhere, the South. So we're having fun.
And testing? Just make sure it works. Hi, everybody!
Hey. So we've been talking about celebrating diversity, because right now in our political climate in our country, there's a lot of fear of diversity, it seems. And so we have been going to churches and talking about how to celebrate diversity. And, you know, we're all unique. It's kind of it's interesting because we're all unique emanations of the one. You know, we're all one. We're all one. Yet we're all different, like snowflakes. And how can one be better? How can one snowflake be better than another snowflake? It just doesn't work that way. So we're here talking about that. Did you want to say something? If I let him speak once in a while.
We do this all the time now. Everyone say with me. Today. Oh, come on, y'all. Y'all be better than that. No. That's weak.
Today.
I am connected.
To a power
that is greater than I am.
And
the reason why I wanted you to say that, because see, we're talking about diversity this morning. We're talking about oneness. Yeah? And so when we're talking about oneness, we have to go back and remember there's only one thing here. Not two, not three. There's only one thing here. Oh, we need one. And I'm talking about one with the big O. One. Yeah? We used to have this practitioner that in Fremont. I used to love his treatments because he had this baritone voice. And the first words out of his mouth on every treatment he would do, he would walk up to the microphone and he would say, "There is one, 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 one." And I mean, this voice would illuminate across the street. And I go, "Woo, go head on. I got the message."
So spirit loves diversity. Yeah. Spirit loves diversity. You know, there's not one kind of flower. There's hundreds of flowers. There's not one instrument in the orchestra. There's many different instruments that make the whole. I remember flying across the country once, looking down at the earth and seeing how it changed. You know, if it would be brown and then mountains and then green, and I thought, how could anyone say that diversity is not the natural thing, because it's everywhere that we look. Desmond Tutu said, "We inhabit a universe that is characterized by diversity. There's not just one planet or one star. There's galaxies of all different sorts, a plethora of animal species, different kinds of plants, and different races and ethnic groups." He said, "How could you have a soccer team if everyone was a goalkeeper? Or an orchestra if everyone played French horn?"
Yeah, that's true. So, but I just want to dovetail off that for a little bit. Is that I want to go back. Let's go back and unpack this word one for a moment. Is that we know what we know, what we know, what we know. Yes?
Yes.
Okay, yes, we know. We know. But there's this one word that sometimes creeps up on us and we buy into it sometimes. It's called amnesia. Sometimes we forget we're connected to this one thing that is greater than we are. We get amnesia. So when we forget, then we start looking out there to fix it. We, you know, to do things that, you know, to fix it. You know. And that, and then when it fixes it, then, hey, I'm going to feel better. I'm going to feel connected. You know, it's like, no. Everyone say with me, it's an inside-out job.
It's an inside-out job.
Amen.
So what is prejudice? Prejudice is when we prejudge. We judge someone or something by the way it looks or the way it speaks or the way it's different from us without knowing anything about it. Have you ever had the experience of seeing someone that looks very different from you, and maybe you took a step back? Maybe it was a homeless person or someone that had a lot of tattoos and piercings, and yet you somehow get engaged in a conversation with that person, and they're remarkable. You have a lot in common. We have more in common with people who are different than we are, than we think. So it's just getting past that. And how we view other people is how we view ourselves. It's all a reflection from what's inside, like Damien's wonderful reading. I'll tell you a story. I used to work in San Francisco years ago, and I rode the bus every day. At 8 in the morning, I'd get on the bus and go to work. And some mornings, and I moved to San Francisco from the Midwest, where things were a lot different than they were in crazy San Francisco. And I loved it. I looked around and said, look at this. Look at everyone's different. Look at all the different ethnicities and clothes and people. And oh, this is, I celebrate that. It's wonderful. And some mornings I would get on the bus and go, I don't know about them. And oh, look at how she's dressed. And wow, they're really loud in the back. And one day it sort of dawned on me. I thought, what's the difference here? The difference was me. I'm probably up with the same people. The 8 o'clock bus has probably got most of the same people on it every day. But if I was feeling good about myself, I saw beauty. If I was feeling bad about myself, then I If I'm feeling bad about myself, I don't like what I see out there, or maybe I'm afraid of what I see. Sometimes it's when we're fear-based, we say, you are not me, so I should be afraid of you. We sometimes fear people and things that are different from us.
And to that note, when I say we get amnesia, that's one of the things I'm talking about. Because sometimes when we forget, we look at someone and says, I don't know you, you don't know me, therefore, you know, I don't trust you. It's like, no. And so we get into that fear mode. You know? And it's like I mentioned during the first service. It's like, you ever try to get a duck wet? You know, it's like, pour some water on the duck and see how wet it gets. You know, water just rolls off. See, so when you're bathed in this power that is greater than you are, and you know your truth, you know you're connected to this power, you know, it's like stuff gonna show up. Y'all, let me tell you, stuff gonna show up. You know? Cause you got in this teaching doesn't mean stuff doesn't show up. It's gonna show up. Trust me. But here's the difference. When it shows up, we know what to do. We know what to do, we know the truth, right? Be like that duck and step into it, right?
So we're encouraging ourselves and other people to step into the differences.
Step into the differences.
When you feel like stepping back, step in. Get out of your comfort zone and know, remember that we're all one. When you get to know people.
Can I say something?
Let me finish the sentence. When you get to know people, we're all the same. You know, we're all the same. We all have the same interests and loves. Okay, go ahead.
When I was speaking a while ago, I forgot to add this one little thing that I also mentioned during the first service. I went into the grocery store here a while back, and we're talking about, because I don't know you, you see people living in that state of fear. See, that's not us because we know the truth. But when you go outside in the elements and in out there and you see this fear thing, I went to the store, you know, and I'm humming, oh, God is so good to me. I'm singing. I got my cart. I walked up and got in line, and I looked in front of me, and there's this guy packing his 9mm.
In Oregon.
You know, and he's looking on. I said, hey, dude, we're in the grocery store. You know? But that just goes to show you, is that in what I, you know, and I sent him love. I sent him love, knowing that his path that he was on was perfect for him, you know, and I sent him love. But as I looked at him, I had to go back and remember, wow, you know, is that he forgot that there's only one thing here and that we're all connected and joined at the hip as one, because there's only one of us. You know, we're all joined at the hip. We're all joined at the hip. Anyway, go ahead.
So we're kind of an unlikely couple. You know, I'm from the Midwest. I'm from Michigan. Andy's from San Antonio, Texas. And we met in San Francisco. And he was playing in a club on Union Street. And I fell in love with the keyboard player. And we've been together ever since. And this year is our we celebrated our 39th wedding anniversary. You know, with our different backgrounds, Andy wanted to share a story about when he was in the Navy. He joined the Navy when he was 17.
Yes, that was a while back. Felt like yesterday. But anyway, let me tell you, you know, being raised in San Antonio, there's two camps there, two major camps. I was either Baptist or Holiness, and I had a foot in each camp. So, I mean, that doesn't mean that prejudice did not exist in San Antonio. It's just that I never experienced it. I never saw it. So I had, you know, I was oblivious to the idea. I mean, even though you read about it in a newspaper or you might, you know, hear about it, but I never knew anything about that. When I got out of boot camp, they sent me to a wonderful town called Pensacola, Florida, a couple of miles off the state line of Alabama. And so, you know, I'd been there for a while, and me and a bunch of guys, we decided we would rent a car and go to New Orleans, to the Mardi Gras. So we put on our dress whites. We had this old jalopy. You had to kick, you know, had to push it, start it, you know. You know, had three shifts on the column, put in second gear and pop the clutch, you know. And so we left the base, and you know, we were all happy, and then 4 or 5 miles down the road, there was this burger joint on the left side of the road. I never forget. And we pulled up, and I saw this huge sign, colors in the back. Oh, wow, okay. So I told the other guy, I'm the only blood. Everybody else was white. You know, I said, okay, I'll go around in the back and, you know, order my burger. No, 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 no. We're in uniform. We're government property. We live together. We fight together. We die together. I said, no, no, we're not dying today. I'll go around the back. Somehow or another, I let them talk me into going in the door. And I want you to imagine that you're in like Denny's or somewhere, this huge restaurant. You know, it's pretty big, you know, and people, dishes clinging, people laughing and talking, babies screaming. Even the babies were screaming. You know? I walked in the door, and you could hear a pin drop. It was dead silence, dead silence. And, you know, and I kept saying, no, I'll, you know, my friends got in an argument with the waiter because, you know, they wanted to order for me. And it's like, you know, I'm saying, come on, guys, let's kind of like go. Nobody's saying, even the baby stopped crying. Yeah, and so I'm looking around, and people was like digging underneath the table, you know, digging up there, and I'm looking at sticks, bats, all kinds of stuff came out. We all backed up toward the door. Do you know that, oh, thank goodness, the jalopy cranked right up. We didn't have to push start it. They ran us all the way back to the base. That was my first exposure to, you know, this is real. This is real. This stuff is real. And so I that was my first exposure to what prejudice is like. I don't know you. You look different from me. And I don't, you know, it's like, wow. It just stayed with me.
So when we were first together and first married, we lived in San Francisco, which is a very culturally diverse city. And so we weren't unusual. There were a lot of interracial couples, a lot of different ethnicities in San Francisco. And then we lived there for many years, and then we moved to Fremont, where we found Science of Mind in Dr. J. Scott Neal's church, and we learned about principle, and we learned a way to live our lives better, and we embraced the teaching and started taking classes immediately and became ministers, and we served at that church. And then we we ended up going to Roseburg, Oregon, which Dr. Marcia Pierce retired, and we'd been camping in that area, and we said, we love Roseburg, let's go check it out. So we checked it out, and they offered us a job. And after that, I discovered that Roseburg was white, almost all white. It was poor, and it was very conservative. And we didn't really realize that till after we said yes. And we thought, well, that's interesting. I wonder why we were called here. And, you know, because if you know anything about the history of Oregon, I did a little research. Oregon was admitted to statehood in 1859, and it was the only state admitted with a constitution that forbade black people from living, working, or owning property in Oregon. And it was illegal for blacks to move there until 1926. So it was, you know, there was a history that we came upon. But, you know, Andy talked about water running off a duck. Because we've been together so long, we sometimes forget that we're different. And people, we have not experienced prejudice in Roseburg. And someone said to us, you know, you're in denial. And maybe we are. I mean, people look at us, but we don't get offended. And, you know, I think, like Andy says, it's consciousness. It's our consciousness that draws us to that. And we get out in the community. Andy was a Little League coach for many years.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I have to tell you about this. I've taught, you know, I've been coaching Little League, you know, for 30-some years probably. But in Roseburg, that was like 5 or 6 baseball fields out there. And I looked around, you know, and I'm the only blood out there. I'm it. And I went, yes! You know, I get a chance to spread some color in the place, you know?
Yeah. But he became just Coach Andy.
Just Coach Andy. You know, the kids and the moms and the dads, they, you know, kids just love me. They just saw that, you know. And so I just want to share this quickly with you, is that when we talk about a conservative neighborhood, you know, we're surrounded at where we live in Roseburg. I'm surrounded by evangelicals. And so, you know, Dave, bless his heart, my next door neighbor, we get into some interesting conversations, you know, it's like, and like I mentioned it before, you know, he'll look at me sometime while we're doing stuff, and he says, Andy, yeah, well, what's up, Dave? Have you been born again? And I look at him, I say, you know, every moment I'm born again. Every moment is new. Yes, I'm born again. I'm washed. Yes.
And he looks at Andy and kind of like, oh, they can't quite figure us out. We're like the strange folks from California, but they still like us, you know. So how do we celebrate diversity rather than being frightened by it? How do we celebrate it? Well, one way is leaning in. And another way is to learn about different cultures, to educate yourself, learn the language, watch some foreign movies, invite someone different for dinner. We're going to show a short video to you in a couple of minutes. And it's like Arun Gandhi, when we heard him speak once, said when his grandmother moved to the United States, she said that she was surprised that no one greeted her and welcomed her and that no one spoke in the halls. Nobody seemed to know each other in this condominium complex they were in. So she invited everyone for a potluck at the community center and put posters all over. And everyone came with all these different nationalities of dishes and food and broke bread together. And then when they saw each other at the mailbox, they'd say, oh, how's your son? How's your daughter? How's your job? They got to know each other. So there's something about sharing food that really, really makes it wonderful. And as you'll see in this video, you know, love is always the answer. Love is always the answer.
And I just like to share is that greet everyone with a smile. Let love go before you. Even before you open your mouth and say the first word, let that love energy just spread. Let it go out before you. And that draws in reciprocal love. And everything unlike it will wash away.
Just for some, but for
interesting how that brings tears to a lot of people's eyes. It does. It's very touching. And breaking bread together is a wonderful way to lean into our differences and to learn. We learn so much. There's so much richness when we give up that fear and just enter in and lean in. Desmond Tutu says that there is room for everyone, for every culture, race, language, and point of view. It is only when we respect even our adversaries and see them not as ogres, but as fellow human beings that deserve respect. Ken Gordon, when we heard Ken Gordon speak at a conference in Eugene last year, he said, it's time to tell the truth about who we are, to speak up before we get angry and bitter, and stand in our truth wherever we are. It's easy to take that path of least resistance, but we stand up and speak our truth. Sometimes I don't get upset until I get angry, and then I speak my truth. But he's talking about doing it before we get angry and bitter. So I'd like to close with a loving kindness meditation. So if you feel comfortable, close your eyes, take a breath. And say these words to yourself. May I be happy. You can say it silently. I forgot to say that. But you can say it out loud if you want. May I be loved. May I be safe. May I be free from suffering. Now think of someone that you love.
a child, a spouse, a friend. Just think of someone that you love deeply and say this silently to them. May you be happy. May you be loved. May you be safe. May you be free from suffering. And now think of someone that it's difficult to love. Someone who bothers you, who brings up all of your feelings, who maybe it's difficult to forgive. Someone that's difficult to love. And say this to them in your mind. May even you be happy. May you be loved. May you be safe. May you be free from suffering. What we give out comes back. What we give out comes back. And for the closing prayer, Andy's going to sing a song that came to him all as one piece when he wrote this for this talk.
Don't let this life pass you by. Stand tall and let your truth, let it shine. You're in charge of your destiny. It's only love that will set you free. Love is the only thing. Look straight ahead, no matter what life may bring. Let's not divide by class or race. Don't buy into the rage and the hate. It's only love that will let us see. Oh, it's only love that will set the world free. Love your fellow man, no matter the color. I know we can. We're all a part of the human race. So let's not forget, please don't hesitate. Oh, can we respect and love one another? Even though we don't agree with each other, we are one people living on the planet. We will build or destroy together. Oh, so can we love and let love see? Oh, it's only love that will set the world free. Don't wait for the by and by, thinking it will come from somewhere in the sky. It's only up to you and I, so let's live it from the inside out. Oh, can we respect and love one another, gay or straight? Let's love each other. We are one people living on one planet. We will build or destroy together. Oh, so can we love and let love see. Oh, it's only love that will let the world be. Set the world free. only love will set the world free. Love is the strongest force that I know. You only need to recognize and know. Love will heal, love can reveal all you need to know, and then you let it go. You see, I never thought, I never knew this love could be so wonderful in you. I let it lead me and guide me on my way. I'm here to testify and say, it's only love, it's only love that can set me free. It's only love that will let me see I am whole and complete. It's only love that lives in me. Let's say it again. It's only love that can set me free. It's only love that will let me see him. I am whole and complete. It's only love that lives with me. One more time. It's only love that can set me free. Yeah. It's only love that will let me see I am whole and complete. It's only love that lives with me. Only love, only love, only love, only love, only love, only love, only love. It's only love.
Mindy, bless you.